Now, the real reason we're here today is David and Erica. They are our newest millionaires. The first thing we want to do today is we want to present them a very big check, and then they've agreed to say a few words and answer a few questions from the media. So, let's get that check first. David and Erica, come over here. We're going to put you in the middle. You're going to have your picture taken a lot here in the next minute or so. But there it is. The second biggest ever. This is called paparazzi.
Erica, you going to get
anybody who hasn't gotten the picture?
Before taxes are out.
Okay, let's put that down there for a moment. David and Erica, why don't you come over here and say a few words, and then they might have a question or two for you.
Oh, I do this on a... We're building a legacy. We're never going to do this again. So
you
got to turn. I
got to
turn the tables.
We want to turn the cameras back on you guys.
Yeah. All you photographers, don't worry. I'm not looking for a job. Thanks for coming. I appreciate the governor being here. I'm thinking it's a slow political day because it only cost me $2 to meet him. So we've been having a lot of fun with this. Our community's great. Our friends are great. You know, if I told my friends before, or our friends, if you're friends with us on Tuesday, you're friends with us today, period. We don't want to lose them. They're who defines us, family, friends, church. We're not going to change. You know, I'm still wearing the old Nebraska hat. It's not going to change. It's been a whirlwind. It's been scary, somewhat. Fun, mostly fun.
Yeah.
That's what we're all about, having fun. We have a great team put together. That's all we've been working on since then. It's a lot of work.
You know, you think winning lottery's fun, and, you know, you dream of what you're going to do, but the reality is the meetings. New people you get to meet.
We've been very lucky that we have family that's in the business. They've been pointing us in great directions, meeting great people. We got a team together to build a legacy for generations to come. We also, that same team is going to protect us from ourselves. So there's not going to be any stories a few years down the road that we're going to be in a ditch somewhere. I can guarantee that. Other than that, and we have a connection to you guys. My wife used to babysit Ashley, the reporter over here. So, you know, the 6 degrees of separation in Nebraska is down to 2. So, it's fun. The hardest part, I think, for especially my wife, was retiring.
Yeah, you know. I had every intention to work until I was 40, and I went into work on Monday and retired immediately.
But it's been great, and we want to share with everybody. You know, everybody knows you buy a ticket, you dream. When your numbers hit, it all goes out the window. Because you're, what do I do now? You know. The first thing I did after I noticed our numbers won, you know, I just prayed that, you know, God has a plan and we're on board with it. That's all there is to it. It's going to be great. I know it is. So, are there any questions? I mean, be glad to answer anything.
How often do you guys play? Do you do the typical thing?
Yeah. He plays weekly, and if it gets big enough, it's Wednesday and Saturday or whatever. But
yeah, and I think we broke even.
As much as we put in, I think.
But as far as the person who won in Massachusetts, he's a little luckier than us because his was a quick pick.
Yeah,
I found that out.
We found that out this morning that his was a quick pick.
Yeah.
So. Like you said, we earned it. We had to put some thought into the numbers.
Are these numbers you always
No, we've normally done quick pick, but the significance is the one was a mistake, but the rest of them are our family, our immediate family, our kids, and birth dates.
Yeah. And
which is a mistake?
The one.
Well, some people call it a mistake, some people call it a miracle, and some of my friends have called it my IQ, so. But
how
is it a mistake? As soon as I... We always have an extra space, and the few times I pick my own numbers, I'll fill in my favorite number, my lucky number at three. Apparently, number one was my lucky number, but it just as soon as I set the paper down, my hand went straight to the one.
Because we have two 13s, so we can't obviously pick it twice, so we always had to have an extra number, and so it's always been three, and for whatever reason, his hand went straight to the one. He's like, nobody's birthday's one, and so in hindsight, it was my birth month.
Yeah. So. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. You both seem pretty grounded. It sounds like you've been pretty smart in your playing. So what do you attribute in your background having the smarts to pause and do what sounds like is the right thing with all of this?
I think it's just the way I was raised, you know, the way my wife's been raised.
It's kind of like uncharted waters. We don't really even know. So if we can get our team together to guide us where to go next.
Not to mention, you know, we've asked family and friends to make sure we
to
stay
grounded.
Keep
us grounded, and if and, we get too big, to rope us back in.
Yeah, have you noticed the size of our uncles? It's the biggest thing is not losing sight of
who we are
before on Tuesday, who we were. You know, there's no little people in our lives then. There's no little people in our lives now. We both retired at work, and I told all the people I've worked with them guys for. You know, 16 years, some of them. And I've seen them, you know, get married, become parents. I've seen their kids grow up. That's a big part of who we are. That's what it's all about. It's the same with the neighbors. It's life. It's all it is.
And he said, I got the short end of the stick of retiring because now we're together 24/7. Yeah.
She's going to regret it.
What are your ages?
48 and 36. I worked at a hospital as a nurse's aide and secretary for 15 years.
I worked in the interior completions department over at Duncan Aviation. So.
I had every intention of staying on till I was 40. Who can say they can retire at 40? I love my job, and I went in, reality set in, and I'm like, you know, I have a coworker who was having surgery, and so I'm like, well, maybe I'll just get him through her medical leave. And then I went in, and you know what, I'm just done. So effective immediately, you know, I'm just like, I don't really need to work. Do I, you know, I love my job, but let me just, like, enjoy this roller coaster and not have to worry about setting the alarm clock for 4:10 a.m.
As conservative as your plan sounds, I think we'd all like to know if you've got that one wild hair thing that you're thinking, you know what, I'm going to do this. Can you tell us what that might be?
Go ahead.
Yeah, for me, it'll be delivered in about 2 weeks, and that's a red Corvette. That's it. So.
New one?
Oh, a new one.
Yeah. That's what I asked Michael. Is it an older style one? He's like, no.
How about you, Erica?
Just probably a house. You know, we've never really had new cars, nothing. So just the dream house. And he said he's going to leave the interior decorating up to me and my mom. He's just going to back out. The only thing he wants control of is the man cave and the garage. Those are the only two things he wants total control of.
Did this change your holiday plans at all?
Depends on what happens after today.
It could.
I don't know if you've read the newspaper article, the parts about my mom. We are, we're going to go deliver a record player to her. That's what she wants.
He told her, Mom, we won the Powerball, and he's like, I can get you anything you ever need or want. And she's like, all I want is a record player. I have all these records and nothing to play them on. And so he's going to take that to her.
Where were you
guys
when you cut
at one? Ironically, I was in, just got up and turned the TV on, and instantly, the second after the TV turned on, the numbers popped up. So, I mean, after I screamed in every room of the house for about a minute, jumping up and down, I had to sit down because I was done. I was spent. So.
And I was at work. He had shot me a text that said, "We're millionaires. We won the Powerball." And I called him and I said, "Yeah, right. We did not. Shut up." And I almost hung up on him. And I said, "Send me proof that we won." So he texted me a picture of the winning ticket, and a coworker pulled up on her smartphone the winning numbers, and sure enough.
And from about the time that I realized it was a winner to the time the bank opened, I mean, that ticket weighed a ton. It just weighed a ton. You know, and I went into where I worked part-time, just not too far from my house, and I've worked with them guys for, again, I've been there for 16 years, almost 16 years. And I told them, I'm going to tell you two things I thought I'd never say. I won the lottery, I'm going to retire. Then I had to prove it. So fortunately, there was a newspaper on the table, and I showed them. But everybody's happy for us. Everybody's wishing us the best. They're praying for us. Church that Sunday was just incredible from all the outpouring of sport.
We normally have 70 to 80 people at our church. Sunday, we had 156 people at our church. There was fights for parking spots.
it's all been good so far.
What's the church?
Out in Valley, just the community church.
Days later, can you guys still believe that you're here, that we're all here?
No. We're pinching ourselves every day and trying to wake up from a dream. You know, you drive by the billboard and you're like, "God, what I would do with that money." And then you win, and it's exciting but scary all at the same time.
Have you bought a Mega Millions ticket?
I'm going to give somebody else a chance.
So have you spent some money already?
Yeah.
On the car?
Yeah.
You plan to take a wild vacation?
We got to stay grounded.
We want to stay somewhat normal as much as we can.
The thing that went away is, you know, everybody's got a household routine, and we haven't had one since went away. And that takes its toll.
Mostly lining up people to help manage the money.
It's a full-time job.
And I think Thursday and Friday night, I think between the two of us, we've had 6 hours of sleep at night, maybe. You know, you can't sleep. Your head's just running, and so you get up and.
And it's the first.
You can only go so far on that.
It took 3 days to develop saliva again. It takes a physical toll. It really does. I mean, I know I've lost some weight. I've lost a lot of weight. I got no more fluff here. It's awesome. But we're finally starting to sleep better, eat better. So, I mean, it's getting back to somewhat normal, even though normal is going to be different. Totally
any
different.
Any downside to it, or people coming up to you and saying?
No, the community of Gretna has been great. You know, we've had, you know, just everybody coming up to, you know, it couldn't happen to a better couple, or congratulations, or it's just been so positive.
The biggest comment everybody's making is they're glad it's happened to somebody local, you know, not somebody passing through. So.
Did you guys decide to take the long
term? We haven't decided.
Yeah. We're going to decide that. Our legacy, like I say again, we have a legacy team built up, and we're looking at all the options. It's
this might be like an odd question. Are you guys playing the Mega Millions jackpot?
No.
No,
we're gonna
give somebody else a chance.
Yeah, to experience what we are.
Do you know how much you'll find to get out of tax?
No.
Not certain. Not certain. I mean, it's more what I had Tuesday.
No.
Not really, no.
When you talk about a legacy team, are you talking about an accountant,
lawyers?
No.
Everything. Lawyers.
We just want it to go on for generations. We want our kids and our grandkids, because we are due with the grandchild in May, or in March. And so we just want something to be there for them, so they don't have to worry.
So how many people would be on the
team? I'm guessing probably about a dozen, at least, you know. That way, like I say, probably the biggest determining factor of what goes on, you know, for our legacy is going to be us, just because of our lack of experience. So we need to surround ourselves with experienced people, and they're trusted people, because like I say, they're part of our family. So They're teaching us real well, and they're really taking their time with it because they know they have to, because, you know, we've never dealt with anything like this. And we've heard, you know, we've heard stories, and we don't want to be one of them other stories where 5 years down the road we got nothing. So, and that's the most important thing. Your mind goes from your daily, you know, providing a roof for your, putting a roof over your family's head, providing food, providing whatever you can, and that's taken care of. Now it's, you instantly, that stress leaves, and then instantly it's the stress of, you know, your legacy. So. Pardon?
We're not going to answer that. We want to leave the kids out.
No. I explained to them that we will do everything we can for them, but we're not going to be welfare parents, and they understand that. I mean, they're hardworking people. They know the values of it, and I don't want them to lose the values of that. I mean, I can't let them do that. So.
Go ahead.
Yes, if necessary. I mean, you know, I'm not going to let them live on the street, but I'm not going to let them.
We're not just going to hand it to them. And
we're certain that they've been raised well enough to know, and they've proven it to us that they've been raised well enough to know that they have to take care of themselves.
And work hard, work ethic or whatever.
Exactly right.
Work for what you have.
Andrew, go ahead.
You know, a lot of times we ask people when bad things happen, why does God
Yeah, you know, the first thing, like I say, after the euphoria was over, you know, I put my head in my hands and I prayed to keep me grounded, to keep us safe. I prayed for my community, you know, my family, my friends. I prayed that, you know, that it would to help be guided so that good will happen. You know, there is a lot of bad in the world. I mean, it's just part of the world. But there's a balance, and you stay true to who you are, you know, and bad won't happen. So.
Do you plan to give some away?
That's, you know, the legacy team. We're working on that. There are plans working, but again. Nothing's been determined yet. It's too soon still. I mean, there is. It's incredible. I retired from a full-time job, and I picked up another one, and so did she. So, you know, and now we're working Saturdays and Sundays, too, so, you know. But.
Do you have any idea when it might, like, sink in, when this might change my life register?
It
kind of registered when I saw that check. You know, you can't really put a number or whatever, but it's like, wow. You know, it's just that.
Yeah. It's starting to register because, you know, we used to talk about, you know, our paychecks, thousands of dollars, and now, I mean, we're not. Yeah. It's numbers that you can't, we still don't comprehend the numbers. And it's incredible. You know, the team that we have together, they deal with this stuff every day, so they talk about it like we talk about hundreds of dollars. So, you know, that gives us more confidence in what's going on and what's going to go on. She told me if I did, I'd be doing it by myself.
My whole family's here, and I'm...
Yeah, we're family-oriented. And like she said, the community's been great. You know, and I've seen that time and time again. Since I've been in the state since 84. You know, the community, all the Nebraska communities, the whole... If you're a Cornhusker, I mean, you're awesome. You're good people. You know that. We've all seen that. So I think going anywhere else would be a big mistake. You know, we haven't determined any of that because we're still trying to figure out, you know, we're still trying to keep a balance. You know, we want to go and we don't go over the top and then in 5 years, you know, have nothing. So
we want to take our time and be able to plan our dream house. But we're probably thinking, yeah, you know, I grew up in Gretna. My kids go to Gretna. And so just maybe out in the country where you can... Not have to touch your neighbor when you reach out the side window or something.
How long have you guys been married?
Coming up on 16 years in the spring. So.
But no exotic trips? You're not going to go around the world?
I haven't considered that. I mean, we're not that far along yet. She is, really wanting to travel. She always has. And I'm more of a homebody, stick around close. So, I mean, we're going to have to compromise like we always have.
I said, like an African safari would be kind of funny. He goes, I'll get you a zebra and we can stay here.
So, see? Compromise. You got to play to win.
Yeah.
We've been playing for, boy, who knows how long. Like I say, we might have broke even, but you got to play to win. Don't go nuts.
Potentially, somebody's got to win it. You know, yeah. The odds are somebody's going to win, so you might as well play and enjoy the ride afterwards.
What's the biggest prize in the lottery you won previously?
$12, I think.
Oh.
And I was on a. Quite a dry spell. I just about gave up, you know, and I just tried it. You know, just figured, you know, it's $2, and when you don't win, you see somebody else that wins. You're thinking, you know, I had a stake in that, a small stake, and you see their how happy they are, and it makes you feel good.
But can you play it every Wednesday and Sunday? Would you buy more than one ticket? Or
just no, it's Wednesday. I usually buy one most of the time. If it's really really big, maybe twice a week. Buy one ticket twice a week, so two a week. But
so your regular player, not big.
Exactly, yeah. Right. I have a hard time gambling. I don't go to the boats. I mean, I can't gamble $20 away without feeling guilty. So $2, I'm up to $2.
Any final questions? All right. Hey, congratulations, you guys.
Thank you.